Welcome to the My Aged Care video that explains how you can effectively use the waitlist function in the provider portal to manage your services. A key benefit of maintaining a waitlist in My Aged Care is that it enables the contact center and assessors to send referrals in situations where you may not have current availability to provide a particular service. Your waitlist availability is also displayed on the My Aged Care service finders. By the end of this video, you should understand how to set up a waitlist in the provider portal, add a client to your waitlist, and manage clients on your waitlist. It is important that the service availability information is updated regularly, as it is used by assessors, contact center staff, and consumers when researching providers. To offer a waitlist in the provider portal, the person assigned the role of outlet administrator in the portal needs to set the waitlist availability status to yes. The waitlist function will need to be configured for each service item under an outlet. If you receive a referral and do not have current availability to provide the service, the person assigned team leader role for the outlet can accept the referral to waitlist if one is set up for that service type. Waitlisted referrals will appear in the waitlist tab in the service referrals section for your outlet. Note that for home care package clients, you must accept the referral in My Aged Care and submit entry information to DHS prior to the package take-up deadline. Otherwise, their package will be withdrawn. The package take-up deadline is found under the Approvals tab in the client record. When you are able to provide services to a waitlisted client, you need to action their referral from the Waitlist tab. Review the referral summary and client record to confirm that you are still able to provide services to the client prior to removing them from your waitlist by drawing them down into service. If you draw down a client into service, the client's referral will move to the Accepted Services Pending tab until service delivery information is recorded, after which the referral will move to the Services in Place tab. For home care packages services, a client's details will move to the Services in Place tab once their entry information submitted to DHS flows through to My Aged Care. Alternatively, if you cannot provide services to a client, you will need to select a rejection reason from the drop-down list. If you reject a referral, the user who issued it will receive a notification to follow this up. The referral will be removed from your waitlist and will no longer be visible in the portal. A client may choose to have their referral broadcasted to a number of providers. If the client is drawn into service or accepted by another provider, they will be removed from any waitlist they are on for that service type. Providers will be sent a notification if a client has been removed from their waitlist by being accepted into service by another provider. That concludes the video on how to manage your waitlist in the provider portal. For links to additional information and support, click on the description box below.